family. At this time, we're going to have who wants to share a matter.
Come on, Mother.
This is such an amazing, special moment. Stephanie, in the short time that I've known you, I'll share the scripture. And I feel like it really reminds me of you. And this is from Matthew 5:5. And I love the New Living Translation. It says, God blesses those who are humble, for they will inherit the whole earth. And you are on the brink of receiving this amazing inheritance right now that is the kingdom of heaven. And you have so much knowledge, so much that God has already sowed in you, but you have such a humility to sit down with the scriptures and allow to read the same scriptures but allow them to touch you differently.
Wow.
So I'm so excited to have you, my sister, in Christ. Come on. I'm going to be
your Bible, you know, all the scriptures, and just the way that you allow the woman to teach it, and just give it like the reason. You were a noble character, and I really believe that God is going to do a big change in your life. So,
that I'm here and just this journey that I've been on. So I want to share this. It's a passage in Psalms 51, and I chose Psalms 51 because throughout the summertime I was really struggling just in my faith, and I was just praying so much for God to send me His people and to show me His truth and to show me the truth in His word. And I found myself reading Psalms 51 a lot, because if I was struggling or when I was struggling then, I would read it and I would just read it like,
So
it says, have mercy on me, O God, according to your unfailing love, according to your great compassion. Blot out my transgressions, wash away all of my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. And I would pray this prayer, just having the faith to know that God was going to send His people to me to work in my life, just so that I can enter into His kingdom and do His will and follow His steps and just be in alignment with Him. So in the summertime, I wrote this. It's like a poem, but it was really a letter to God, and it's titled Israel, and I want to share it with all of you. Who am I to think I deserve to do what I want? To think this is my life and I own it? I don't. You gave me a choice. You gave me free will. And my choice hasn't been to align myself to your will. It's been to do what I want after you have saved me. After you brought me out of Egypt. After you brought me out of the wilderness. After you died for me. And I still feel you. I still rebel. I'm still Israel in her spiritual immaturity, even though you showed me your pillar. Even though you appeared to me and showed me how to worship. You showed me how to enter into your temple. You showed me how to sacrifice, and still I deny you. I deny you to myself. I deny you to others. I kill you over and over again when I actually deserve to die for my sins. And yet you still forgive me. You still love me. You still give me complete and total mercy. You said that you still have a plan to prosper me and not to harm me. You said that you will give me the desires of my heart. You said that if we confess with our mouths and repent and be baptized, that you are just to forgive. You said that if we seek you, we will find you. You said that nothing can separate us from your love. You said that if we commit our plans to you, they will be established. But still, my sinful nature still does what it wants. The sin in me still chooses what is against you. My flesh and my spirit are still fighting each other, and my flesh is winning. But still, you told us to seek you with our whole hearts. You told us that if we abide in you, you will abide in us. You told us that greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world.
Right.
You told me that Jesus came to save me and not to condemn me. So all I can do is cry out to you. All I can do is listen to you. All I can do is give you all of me. So here I am 3 months later in total surrender to God. And
do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, that he came to earth, that the sin's way? Do you believe that Jesus was the Son of God, that he died for your sins and resurrected
for
your sins?
I do.
I do. Yeah.
That Jesus is Lord.
We're now going to baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. All of these things are going to be washed away. You're going to be added to God's kingdom,
amazing.
And you're going to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah. Wow.
Come on, jump.
All right.
Yes.